This video is sponsored by Skillshare. The ability to read awoke inside of me some long, dormant craving to be mentally alive. People don't realize how a man's whole life can be changed by one book. That's a quote by Malcolm X, who's a hero of mine. It might seem kind of strange to start off a list of the five books that have changed my life the most with an autobiography, especially a biography about a person who is such a contentious figure. But to me, Malcolm X represents the power of transformation, how someone who originally was a hustler, a drug dealer, a degenerate, after landing himself in prison and going through immense drug withdrawal, he found education. He found virtue, discipline, books. He stayed up until 3 or 4 a.m. every night reading books from the prison library. And in fact, when he started out, he didn't even know how to read properly or even speak properly. So he grabbed a dictionary and he rewrote the entire dictionary just so he could get his vocabulary right. Through the developing of new ideals, Malcolm X went from drug dealer to becoming one of the most powerful orators in the civil rights movement. And it's unfortunate that right as he was discovering peace, brotherhood, a totally new framework that a lot of people don't know about, he was assassinated. But nevertheless, this book is an insanely powerful read, especially because throughout my life, there have been so many times where I felt that I've thrown so much time away. Even though I'm not that old, I'm only about to turn 27, but there have been numerous times where I felt, if only I would have done this sooner, or if I would have made this decision instead of that, or man, I feel like I've thrown away a good chunk of my life. Stories like this remind us that, you know what, even if you feel that your time has been lost, there's always time to transform and to emerge as the person you would like to be. And if you ever feel like, my transformation is too severe, it's too late for me, just know that a drug dealer, a hustler, someone whose father was murdered at a young age by the KKK, found a way to become the person he always wanted to be. The autobiography of Malcolm X, I would definitely recommend checking that book out. The second book on this list is The Slight Edge by Jeff Olson. There have been several books that have addressed this concept of small daily actions and the enormous leverage that they can have. Some of them are The Compound Effect by Darren Hardy or a book called Kaizen. But this is my favorite book of this type, and I think it's the single most powerful concept that any creative, any entrepreneur needs to hear when trying to make their thing happen. So often we get driven into this idea that we need to take large Herculean efforts every single day, give 120% every single day, and if you're not hustling with all your might, then you're doing it wrong. So often the game of success is about attrition. It's about staying in the game as long as possible and staying in the game while doing the small, simple, correct disciplines rather than taking on Herculean efforts one day and giving up the next. Time will be your friend or your enemy. It will promote you or expose you. It depends purely upon which side of this curve you decide to ride. If you're doing the simple disciplines, time will promote you. If you're doing the few simple errors in judgment, time will expose you. No matter how well you appear to be doing right now, time is the great equalizer. Perhaps the single most important thing you can do for your work is to figure out the few simple disciplines, the few habits, the few outputs that are required of you, and then resolve to give those disciplines every single day, not for 1 year, not for 3 years, but for like the next 20 years. The efforts that you compound daily towards that large objective, they're gonna pay off. They're gonna pay off even if that target seems insanely far away right now. If you do the few simple disciplines that are required of you every single day, in 5 years, in 10 years, maybe in 20 years, you'll find yourself looking down from a mountain thinking, how'd I get all the way up here? One of the ways that I personally strive to utilize the compound effect is by determining a learning program, finding out skills that I want to learn, and then using a system to learn them. And one platform that has been enormously helpful to me in this regard is Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey, with thousands of inspiring classes for creatives and curious people on topics including illustration, design, photography, videography, freelancing, and more. Skillshare is also very affordable. An annual subscription costs less than $10 a month. As I've said before, this is a resource that I use with quite some frequency. Lately, my favorite class has been a pre-production course by Christopher Rhodes. You might know him as YC Imaging on YouTube. This man has been making high quality music videos as his main source of income for like the last several years. And in this course, he talks through how he picks his locations, his shot list. And this has been very relevant to me because I actually want to make some high quality music videos on this channel in 2020. If you were to use my link in the description box, the first 500 people would get their first 2 months of Skillshare premium membership for free. And you'd also be supporting my channel and helping me produce some videos. The third book that has changed my life the most is called Thought Power by Swami Sivananda. Swami Sivananda was a great Indian sage, and this book talks about an idea that I'm sure you've heard before and perhaps might have rolled your eyes at some point. The idea that our thoughts create our reality, and thinking good thoughts, thinking thoughts in alignment with the things you want to attract into your life, is a very powerful thing to do. I've had a contentious relationship with things like the law of attraction or spirituality. I have spiritual inclinations, but I think so often I've found that the law of attraction community on YouTube, at least, it feels very disingenuous. It doesn't feel real. It doesn't feel authentic. And I often feel like I'm being preached at or sold something. And it's annoying as hell. On the other end of it, I just don't like the idea of people giving up hard work, giving up striving, strategy, for the sake of just attracting what they want into their life. And yet, I have invariably found that when I am thinking positively, and I'm operating from a state of gratitude and alignment, things are just easier. I can get the thing I want much faster. I can get it done faster, and more elegantly, and more happily, with more joy. And this might be a personal bias, but I at least feel that compared to modern speakers on things like spirituality or the law of attraction, speakers of yore, the great sages of India, I just have an inherent trust of them. I just feel that their words carried more weight because they observed penances and austerities, and their minds were devoted to solitude and the seeking of genuine truth. And so if they were to say things like, thoughts create things, you actually believe it. Thought creates the world. Thought brings things into existence. Think of a person as a good friend of yours, and there the thing is created as reality. Think of him as your foe, then also the mind perfects the thought into an actuality. He who knows the working of the mind and controls it by practice is really happy. Be careful of your thoughts. Whatever you send out of your mind comes back to you. Every thought you think is a boomerang. The fourth book on my list is a book called The Miracle Morning by Hal Elrod. It's a very simple book. It talks about the power of establishing a great morning routine. And after reading this book, it became really important to me to find a way to prime my brain every morning, prime it for success. And I do this simply by working out first thing in the morning and meditating. But the story behind how this person, Hal Elrod, discovered his morning routine is actually pretty spectacular. He was going through the recession of 2008. He was losing all of his clients, and he was very, very depressed, overweight, unhealthy at the time. And then he decided that he would simply establish a morning routine that consisted of disciplines by the most successful people in the world. Those disciplines included meditating, affirmations, visualization, exercise, reading, and journaling. He resolved to do that every single morning from 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. And in 2 months, he doubled his income, starting his day off with the right habits that primed his brain for positive thinking and positive action. It changed his life in under 2 months. You may have a morning routine of your own, but maybe you hit it some days and you don't others. Give this book a read. It will definitely inspire you to hit that morning routine every single day. And the final book on my list is a very simple read, but it's especially relevant to creatives, to artists, to entrepreneurs, to people who sometimes struggle with perfectionism, and they struggle to put themselves out there. The book is called Show Your Work by Austin Kleon. Once a day after you've done your day's work, go back to your documentation and find one little piece of your process that you can share. Where you are in your process will determine what that piece is. If you're in the very early stages, share your influences, what's inspiring you. If you're in the middle of executing a project, write about your methods or share works in progress. If you've just completed a project, show the final project, share scraps from the cutting room floor, or write about what you've learned. I've definitely thought about this idea, and I know a lot of people have come to me with this philosophy that I don't want to start on a thing until it's fully formed, until I've got the idea perfect and we've got everything figured out and, you know, the lighting is perfect and everything's in alignment and I'm feeling good today, you know, I had my smoothie today. Oftentimes, conditions are not going to be perfect. And so, regardless of where you are, even if your work doesn't look spectacular, make sure that you're committed to showing your work on a regular basis. In fact, even if your work is imperfect, to show it regularly. I can't tell you how much this has changed my life. This philosophy, this idea, enabled me to take part in a micro-budget feature film, to go out on more auditions as an actor, to try Salesforce Consulting, to make YouTube videos even if they're not great. Show your work. It's a quick read, but it's the mindset that every creative and every creative who struggles with perfectionism needs to push forward. And with that being said, for those of us who are willing to take that energy, take that effort to put our philosophy in real life and transform ourselves, to exercise the compound effect by doing those small disciplines every single day. For those of us who are willing to exercise our thought power in a powerful direction, to work with alignment and think about the things that we want to attract into our lives, to have a great morning routine and to show our work, to us I say, greatness is coming. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Cheers.